Ladies and gentlemen, the President of the United States and Mrs. Reagan.
We are honored indeed to have you carry on this tradition and inaugurate the reopening of our theater by your presence this evening. Thank you, sir, for sharing this evening with us.
Kids who've danced their feet off to give you the kind of a show you'd be proud of. You're going to put them out on the street, too?
Oh, Mr. Dillon, you wouldn't do that, would you?
Not after we put all of our faith in you.
But she called me a whale and a cobra.
Listen, in show business, that's a compliment. Now, what you need is some fun. Now, why don't you come to a quiet corner, and I'll sing you the scores of my last six shows.
Flo on the switchboard. Now, she's an old pal of mine, and she just told me Dorothy Brock has been calling all over town to get Pat Denny.
So that's right.
Denny's in town.
Hello, Pat. Oh, Pat. I can't go on like this any longer. I've tried to forget you, but you've never let me go.
All set until the noise will be over in 10 minutes, and they better not find Denny here.
Hey, how about that dance now?
I'm sorry, Billy, but a friend...
Oh,
anything better than closing the show?
Yes. Who is it?
Peggy Sawyer.
That kid?
Yes, Peggy. She's got a voice that'll panic him, and she can dance rings around Brock.
Big, broad, bright Broadway productions that starts on a peak and then keeps on going up. Before I say anything else, I want to thank the very talented 42nd Street cast. Watching them sing and dance as they did made me wonder if I wasn't seeing the reason why my own career in show business took a different turn. The National Theater opened, as you were told, on this site in 1835, when the occupant of the White House was Andrew Jackson. Americans perched on the roof and peered through the windows of this building to watch the horseback inaugural parades of McKinley and Teddy Roosevelt. They saw the face of the National when they watched newsreels of the inaugural parades of Wilson, Coolidge, and FDR. parades that took place when American admirals still wore cockade caps. And through all those years, the National was staging productions that entertained and delighted the people of this city. In recent years, though, the National fell on hard times. Some even talked of tearing her down. And then a year and a half ago, an army of designers, electricians, and carpenters went to work to save it. They cleaned the exterior. They've refurbished the interior, as we have been able to see tonight, installed a new lighting and a sound system, and added a whole new building, four stories high, for dressing rooms and storage. And they did it all without a penny of government money. Tonight, we're among the lucky first to enjoy the results. A special thanks to Jay Adams, the chairman of the National Theater, to the Schuberts, Gerald Schoenfeld, and Bernard Jacobs, and of course to Carol Laxalt and Betty Wright, the co-chairman of tonight's gala. But I know we want to applaud everyone who had a hand in this wonderful restoration. With this reopening, downtown Washington has a splendid theater and a living link with the past. And speaking as two who live in the neighborhood, we're all delighted. One more thing. Now that the National has reopened, even those of us in Washington will be able to hear the lullaby of Broadway. Thank you. God bless you all. Again. Okay, let's